We're back here today at Lakelet Customs with a bushing install. So today I'm going to install these two bushes on my Mark 1. What happened is that throughout the years, like the age of each car, this wears and tears. So I need to replace this because when I bought the car 3 years ago, it was really like finished, it was klaar. There was like nothing left. And when I installed the exhaust on the car, remember, the guy told me I have to replace this. That was like 2-3 years ago. So I'm finally installing this. It was like 40 rand each, I think, at Stellenbosch Motorspares. That's only in our area, but I'm sure you can get it at your local spare shop. Yeah, you can get it at your local spare shop. So we're gonna install this today. Before starting right off with the car, I want to show you guys I did a little change on the car. I got the car some new tackies and some fresh rubber. So check this rubber out. So initially where I got this rims, this is actually Lloyd's rims that he had on his car. So me and Lloyd did a swap. I swapped him the BBs and he had to just like give me this rims and give me a cast difference. So I took the rims and I bought myself some new 165/50 15 tires and I fitted it today. So thanks to Yazid, I think it's Yazid. So I went to Yazid, he has a local tire shop in Kraaifontein. And I fitted him. Just note, there aren't many tire shops open on a Sunday. So if you guys want your tires fitted before 2 o'clock on a Sunday, I'll put his number in the description below with his location. And you can just contact him if you want to do tire fitment. And his price is very reasonable. He does exhaust welding as well and exhaust replacements. So please go check him out. Please support the guy. He's one of our local guys and he is very popular in the business. So please support the guy. Note, we're in clear daylight now and you guys can actually see the sticker. Just note, this is actually the Instagram sticker, which I just took out the Instagram logo. But this with this, it actually fits together. All the Lakelet Customs is stated here and stated here again, but I mean like it fits together. So I just took out the Instagram logo. But note, this is the new crew logo. And this will be the entry logo. This will be the official logo because I tried many... Well, I tried out many other designs and this is one of the designs I think I might stick with. So, if you guys are interested, my stock will be coming in this upcoming week. I ordered smaller stickers. As you can see, basically the size of the sticker. If you compare it to the window right there, this is a Mark 1 window. So you can compare the size onto your window. And this is the Instagram sticker. Just note the Instagram logo will be here. This sticker will be on the back window as well. The reason why I took out, take off that stick, you guys can see there, the sticky glue still there. The reason why I took off that stick is because the small parts of the sticker was coming off. So I thought, okay, just one time remove the entire sticker and just fit another sticker again. So I'm gonna get a bigger version of that sticker on my back window. And I actually pasted an Instagram sticker. This is the Instagram sticker that's on the window without the Instagram logo. So that's basically the sticker. You guys can see the sticker's size. Compared to the Mark 1 light, and I mean like it's not a bad size. I think I should have made it a little bit bigger for the light, but it's alright there. So Mr. Tyron starting off with the video. So yeah, let's get started. This is the bushing I was talking about. As you can see there, it is actually really messed up at the moment. So I'm just going to remove this. I think that's a 50mm nut right there. So I'll be using a 50mm socket to remove it. And that bracket should come off after the nuts are removed. Then I'm going to replace the rubber. For replacing the rubber, I'm just going to do a comparison to you guys. How a new rubber looks like and compare to the old rubber. This is the comparison between the two rubbers, the one I just removed, and this is the brand new one. You can see the difference in designs because this is the original one released
by the factory of Volkswagen, and this is the one I bought at Stellenbosch Motor Swiss. Well, this was only 40 bucks. So you can feel in quality that this one is better than this one, but unfortunately, because this one did wear, I'll have to replace it. You guys can see actually there. This is actually metal at the bottom, so it's not completely rubber. I think this will do the job for now. I'll probably replace it in the future, but I don't think it will make much of a difference comparing the factory one compared to the aftermarket one, because it basically is designed for the same purpose. The only thing you will be losing is quality and basically the term or the period you were having it on the car. So meaning this one will wear quicker than the original one actually would. But this one only wear the way it did because of the lowness of my car. So hopefully this one won't do the same. So I'm just going to put this one back on the car right now. And there we have the new bushing installed. I think it's called a bushing, but that rubber there, we have the new rubber installed. You can see it has the same purpose, and I mean, like, you can see every part of it, it's almost like it's supposed to be there. It came from factory this way, so that's why I don't think I will have any problems with this aftermarket bushing or rubber. So I'll definitely recommend it. If yours did wear, I'll say rather buy a new one, because it was only 40 rand at my nearest Stellenbosch Motor Swiss or whatsoever store you guys have there with you guys. So I'll say definitely replace it. It's totally worth it, and I'm sure, I mean, like, little things do matter on your car. Just keep that in mind, and that's why I do this. I think this little things to my car, because it actually matters to me, and I want my car to be 100%, and it shouldn't fail me end of the day. So maintenance is key. While the car is actually in the air, you guys can actually see that the tire thread, you guys can see this is actually brand new tires, and I didn't lie to you guys. But like how the tire actually looks, it's an amazing tire. It was a new release tire, and the tire's name is actually iFly right there. So it's a 165, you guys can see there. Let me focus it. 165/50/15. It looks more like a 175 on the wheel, but to be honest, it looks amazing, and I have no complaints. I like the way it actually sits, and if you actually compare it to the Dunlops, I mean, like, I'll actually prefer these above the Dunlops for a 6J. If you want to go above a 6J, I'll recommend the Dunlops, because they look much stretchable. It looks kind of much stretchable than these on the AJ, although these can fit on the AJ. But I'll definitely recommend these tires, and I put the guy's number in the description below. His name is Zaire, and he supplies different profiles, tires in different sizes. So please phone the guy, and he will definitely hook you up with whatever tire you're looking for. So at the moment, I'm just going to finish up the other side. Just no same principle supply as this side. It's not a tough job. You just need like a hammer and a flat. And it wasn't a 50mm, it was actually a 60mm. So I used the 60mm to unlock that nut, and I locked it up with the 16 as well. So just note, after I'm done with the other side, I'm gonna give the car a nice wash. Although the weather is a little bit bad, I'm just gonna wash the car to get the rims clean, because the rims are quite dirty. And I'm gonna give this new tire some new silicone, or some fresh silicone, like it looks a little bit spanky, you know. And I'm just going to give you guys a small cinematics after that of the car. So let's get to with the washing.